one day or day one. You decide. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's episode of 7 Good Minutes, we learn some great tips on how to get yourself out of a rut and get yourself motivated. Enjoy.
When we lose our motivation, what we've actually lost is our focus on the vision we have for ourselves. If you take some time to really think about it, you'll notice that they are not one and the same. When I personally struggle with motivation, it is always because I'm not connecting with my vision on a daily basis. I'm not intentionally keeping my goals and dreams in front of me every single day. I'm not looking at them and thinking about them and connecting emotionally with them. That's why for my previous videos, you know how important I believe a morning routine is in helping me to start each day grounding myself to what I truly find important so that I can stay connected to what is purposeful and fulfilling to me, essentially my why. Why is it that I need to show up today as my highest self? It's so easy to just get sucked into checking social media, responding to emails, and catching up with the news first thing in the morning. Best case scenario, we're just distracting ourselves from connecting emotionally to what's truly important to us. Worst case scenario is we get emotionally attached or even angry about what's going on in the world or what we see other people posting online when we become focused on what everyone else is thinking or doing. So it's no wonder we lose our motivation when we allow that to happen. And really, it's not even that we lose our motivation, it's that we've allowed ourselves to become distracted, where we're not connecting emotionally to our vision, where we're not connecting emotionally to what we truly want to build or create or overcome. Because when we're truly connected to what we're doing and why we're doing it, it's easy to ignore distractions. They aren't even an issue because we're just so focused. We're so focused on the reason we do what we do. And I've found that with clarity comes power. And so for me, it's important to know on a tangible level what I'm actually fighting for. So besides something esoteric like I want to help others, it's important to also have clarity around how we're going to achieve that greater vision. That could mean I'm going to write a book, or I'm going to become a counselor, or I'm going to start a nonprofit. The key is that the more specific our vision is, the easier it is for us to connect with it every morning. Maybe it's something like you want to support your family, so you have to make your mortgage payment this month. That's something tangible that you can easily identify with as far as what you're fighting for. Because there's going to be plenty of days where we just don't feel like doing anything. There'll be days when we don't want to work out. There'll be days when we don't want to work on our side hustle. But I'm of the perhaps unpopular opinion that these are the days that we especially need to do something, to do that workout, to make progress on that side hustle. I believe we have to be resilient and keep our end vision in mind. That doesn't mean I believe we should stuff down our feelings or bypass them in some way. It's good to show ourselves love by having compassion, by giving ourselves kindness. But with the end vision in mind, a deeper compassion, a deeper kindness is to challenge ourselves to figure out how to make ourselves feel like it. I would say this is one of the key differentiators between a lot of the feel-good coaching content I see online and what I believe the way of Kung Fu to be. That part of the embodiment process is learning how to move forward mindfully in spite of discomfort, in spite of obstacles, in spite of not feeling like it. With the end vision in mind, I would say that it's our job to figure out how to stay motivated, how to stay passionate, how to stay connected with what we know in our heart to be of importance to us. And if you're really struggling with identifying what that actually is, you may just need to take some time to really think and feel into it, to figure it out, because you deserve happiness. You deserve to live a fulfilling life. So stop distracting yourself. Take time to get clarity. Because if you're not feeling motivated, it's probably due to what I've heard Tony Robbins call impotent goals. Goals that don't actually fire you up. Maybe they're goals you think you should have, or that you've adopted from other people or society or even a former version of you. But if you're starting off with impotent goals in the first place, you'll never be able to access that drive, that desire to take consistent action towards fulfilling your vision. And for many people, it's not like they're not doing anything. They may be consistently staying busy doing a lot of different things, but just not the things that actually matter to them if they are truly being honest with themselves. And so they're probably reacting and consuming rather than designing and creating. And so they end up losing momentum towards what is actually fulfilling to them, which in turn makes them feel bad. So they feel the need to distract themselves even more. It becomes this downward spiral. And so we must start each day anchored to what is truly important to us. When we do that, staying motivated isn't even an issue the rest of the day. So connect with what you're passionate about each morning. And I don't mean in a rote, mindless way, or trying to give yourself a pep talk with empty positivity. I mean really connect to it, where you're thinking about it, you're feeling it deeply, you're obsessing about it. Maybe it's just semantics, but I don't believe the word obsessing is a bad one. To me, obsessing just means you're connected to purpose, your soul purpose, you're connected to your highest self, you're fired up, you're passionate, you shut out distractions. And so from a practical standpoint, to keep momentum, to help you stay motivated, I recommend picking three things each day that you do no matter what. Three things that you will connect with on a deep level each morning because you know they will help you make progress towards what's truly important to you, your vision.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.